mate. Well, former NFL star O.J. Simpson leaves behind a complicated legacy, passing away aged 76. Investigative reporter David Goldstein covered the trial of the century and joins us now. Good morning to you. Just your reaction first up to his death this morning.
You know, it comes as a shock, obviously, and condolences to his family. But, you know, we always lose track of, everyone called this the O.J. Simpson trial. But, you know, in reality, there are two people who were brutally murdered, and those families today are still grieving as well. So, you know, it's sort of the end of that part of it now that Mr. Simpson has passed away, but those families are still grieving.
It'll forever be that, won't it? Everyone in the world had an opinion at the time on whether he did it or didn't do it. And we had his lawyer on the show a couple of hours ago saying, look, that didn't really matter. It was the prosecution who messed up the case and the police investigation was flawed. For a lawyer to say that, I guess that they would, but does that matter now?
No, I don't think it matters. Again, it matters to the Brown family and the Goldman family because their loved ones are gone. But, you know, it's the way the judicial system worked. And whether you believed he was innocent or guilty, 12 jurors made the decision. And there were no allegations at the time, nor had there ever been, that there was any improprieties with jurors, or if they were coerced in any way, they made their minds up, and you may agree with it or disagree with it, but that's the way the jury system worked.
Look, we're all getting older, but there is a generation who are younger than us, several generations in fact, who will not have any idea about the trial, won't have any idea about you know, his career beforehand and career in movies and everything. Tens of millions of people tuned in to this trial around the world. You have front row seat to it. Describe it to people who may not be initiated.
You know, it was an amazing time in Los Angeles. You know, sort of everything that was happening in the city ended up somehow crossing in that courtroom. I mean, Los Angeles at the time was a very divided city between black and white and Hispanic. There were arguments of whether any black person could get a fair trial. We had the Rodney King trial a couple of years before that, the motorist who was beaten by LAPD, and those officers got off and were found not guilty in the first trial. So everything sort of came together there. And as reporters, as you know, we are the eyes and ears of the public and able to report what goes on in the courtroom that they couldn't see, and also being there for a front row of everything they could see. And it was just an amazing time. Everybody wanted to know. Everywhere I went, any other reporter who covered the trial went, everybody was just hit you up with a million questions on what was going on.
Were you surprised in the end that he was found not guilty? Do you think justice was carried out?
You know, justice was carried out because, again, that's the way the system works. Was I surprised? Yes. There was a lot of evidence, but I'm not the final trier of fact. Yeah. I'm just there to be a witness. So that's what the jury decided, and that's what we have to live with.
Good on you, David. Nice to talk to you today. Appreciate it. Welcome back to the show. O.J. Simpson has died, aged 76, losing his battle with cancer.
US writer and lawyer Clay Travis joins us now from Nashville. Clay, thanks for your time this morning. Now, O.J. Simpson always maintained his innocence. Do you think he did it?
Yes. Thanks for having me on. I think he 100% did it. All of the evidence supports the fact that he did do it. He committed double murder. He never asked for forgiveness or sought any form of redemption. And so I think this is not a day where people should be in the United States sitting around and saying, oh, poor O.J. Simpson. Yeah. I feel for Nicole Brown Simpson, the woman he killed, and Ron Goldman, the man he killed. Mm. I think the evidence is quite clear that he should have spent the rest of his life in prison.
Look, we just had his lawyer on who clearly did his job back in the day. He said it wasn't about O.J.'s guilt or innocence, the trial of the century. It was the prosecution's fault for failing to do their job and a flawed police investigation. Is that about right?
I think this honestly was a sign of broken racial politics. Because of the Rodney King case, which people may or may not remember, that set off riots in Los Angeles, I think a lot of people viewed O.J. as a opportunity to try to get revenge for what happened in the Rodney King case. And so I think the unfortunate fact is there have been certainly issues and a legacy of racism that existed in the United States, existed all around the world. And I think OJ, who was not a victim of racism at all, was able to use racism as his get out of jail free card. I don't blame the lawyers who did the best job, Johnny Cochran, Kardashian, everybody who was involved in this case, Effie Bailey. That's the job of a defense attorney. I've done it. But I think if they were being honest, they would acknowledge that the evidence clearly supported a guilty verdict. And certainly the prosecution didn't do the best job, but the jury knew that he was guilty and didn't care. And that's a tough proposition to get past.
Mm. Yeah, it was one of the most extraordinary cases followed by the world, right? I mean, obviously in America, everyone knew him as a footballer, but across the globe, he was known as the man acquitted of a double murder, a trial that was watched daily.
Yes. It was, can't miss television, 1994, 95. I was talking about this on my radio show earlier. For an American, I just turned 45. There are about 4 or 5 days, the Chancellor, the Challenger explosion, 9/11, certainly, believe it or not, when Princess Di died. A lot of Americans around my age remember exactly where they were when this verdict came down and the jury said that O.J. Simpson was not guilty. I was in high school at the time in 1995. And everyone just about in the U.S., 100 million people in the U.S. alone were watching. Wow. If you were around my age then, everybody knows where they were.
You know, and globally as well. I mean, even with the Naked Gun film, I mean, he got notoriety. Mm. And then this all doubled into it, didn't it? Tens of millions of viewers, as you mentioned, tuned into the trial. As a lawyer yourself, how do you look back on it now quickly?
I look back on it as a sign that sometimes the justice system fails. And it is worth mentioning that he was found civilly liable. In the United States, we have a criminal jury, which would be putting somebody in prison for a violation. He was bankrupted by the court, which found he was responsible civilly for a wrongful death of these individuals. And then he later went to prison for 7 years for another felony criminal conviction in Las Vegas. So, again, he was you're showing some of the highlights from the Naked Gun movies back in the day. I was too young to ever remember OJ as an athlete. You guys may know the movie Terminator. There are reports that they couldn't put OJ Simpson in as the bad guy there because people didn't think that he could actually have committed a murder back in the day when they made that movie. So Arnold Schwarzenegger got the job as the Terminator. But OJ was so beloved, no one could believe that he was the kind of person who could ever commit a murder.
Wow. Clay, really good to talk to you. Thanks for joining us from Nashville, Tennessee.
Great insight. First at 7 a.m., the breaking news we're following from the United States, where OJ Simpson has died of cancer aged 76. The legacy he leaves behind, a complicated one.
As an NFL running back, he was an American sporting hero. But it was his run-ins with the law that he'll be remembered for. OJ imprisoned in 2008 on kidnapping and robbery charges, a sentence many saw as justice finally served after he was acquitted of the killings of his ex-wife and her friend.
It was the car chase that changed everything.
I think I just saw OJ Simpson on the 5 freeway. He's heading north.
For 2 hours in June of 1994, America stopped and watched one of their most decorated athletes on the run.
This is AC. I have OJ in the car.
Okay.
Right now we are okay, but you got to tell the police to just back off. He's still alive and he got a gun to his head.
Orenthal James Simpson was wanted for the murder of his ex-wife, Nicole Brown Simpson, and her friend, Ron Goldman. This slow-speed chase, a stunning fall from grace, the Football Hall of Famer became the fugitive, and then a high-profile defendant in a case dubbed the Trial of the Century, with rolling TV coverage. A critical piece of evidence, a pair of bloodied gloves found at the crime scene.
If it doesn't fit, you must acquit.
The gloves were too small, and Simpson walked away a free man.
We, the jury, in the above entitled action, find the defendant, Orenthal James Simpson, not guilty of the crime of murder.
But his life slid from there. In 1997, he was found liable for their murders in a civil suit. In 2006, he sold a book manuscript titled If I Did It and posed a hypothetical account of the murders he denied. The next year, he was arrested after he and other men invaded a hotel room of sports memorabilia dealers and stole a trove of collectibles. He claimed he was taking back stolen possessions.
How do you plead, Mr. Simpson?
Not guilty.
But a jury convicted him on all counts of robbery and kidnapping. He served the minimum 9 years in a Nevada state prison before walking free in 2017.
I've done my time. I'd just like to get back to my family and friends.
All right, let's bring in 9 US correspondent Alison Petrowski live in LA following this breaking news. Ali, his death is being met with varied reactions this morning.
Yeah, absolutely. Good morning to you, Sarah. And I'd have to say that most people are surprised by this because even though he'd been quite open about his diagnosis, he'd been diagnosed with prostate cancer a couple of months ago, he'd been posting on social media, Sarah, saying that he felt great, that he truly believed that he had beaten this. However, it seems in the last week or so, he had taken a turn. We understand that family members and friends had been called to Las Vegas to say their goodbyes. O.J. Simpson's family relaying the news this morning on Twitter that he had succumbed to that cancer battle, surrounded by his children and his grandchildren. He was, as you mentioned, Sarah, a very polarizing character and certainly a very mixed reaction here in America today. The NFL Hall of Fame has recognized him as one of their greats. Gloria Allred, the lawyer who represented Nicole Brown Simpson's family, said Simpson's death reminds us that the legal system, even 30 years later, is still failing battered women. Fred Goldman, the father of Ron Goldman, one of the murder victims, said, "The only thing that I have to say today is that this is a further reminder of the loss of my son, Ron." And Caitlyn Jenner simply tweeted, "Good riddance." Caitlyn Jenner, formerly Bruce Jenner, she used to work alongside O.J. Simpson many, many years ago as a sports broadcaster. The two were arguably the greatest athletes of their time, Sarah, and clearly no water under that bridge.
All right, Ali, thank you. Hey there, Today fans, Sarah and...
What's my name again?
Oh, my goodness. Carl?
Hey, thanks for watching our YouTube channel, though. Subscribe now for more news, special reports and amazing Aussie stories.
And Carl misbehaving,
whoa,
of course.
That never happens.
Always happens.
What's she talking about?